Welcome to the 18th episode of Police Beat.
In this episode, we will be featuring two Police Academy graduations, the mayor's deployment for downtown Baltimore, the 137th running of the Preakness Stakes, Public Safety Day at Calvin Rodwell Elementary School, and a large gun seizure that took place in the Northwest District. And also in this episode, we'll take a closer look at the launching of BPD-TV.
This is Sergeant Anthony Smith. In this portion of Police Beat, Baltimore Police Department is pleased to announce the first Police Academy graduation in the new year. On February 24, 2012, a ceremony was held at Police Headquarters to honor the graduation of Class 2011-02. The ceremony was attended by the Honorable Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake, as well as Police Commissioner Frederick H. Bielfeld III. These honorable 28 men and women successfully completed 6 months of rigorous training at the Police Academy.
Graduates, raise your right hand and repeat after me.
Do swear.
Do swear
that I will support the Constitution of the United States.
These new officers took an oath to uphold the Constitution and protect and serve the citizens of Baltimore.
Additionally, we'll congratulate Class 1103 as they graduate from the Police Academy. This is the last class that will graduate under the tenure of Police Commissioner Frederick H. Bielfeld III.
Baltimore Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake partnered with Deputy Police Commissioner Anthony Barksdale and Colonel Dean Palmier of the Patrol Division to take a tour of the BPD's summer deployment. Officers from the Baltimore School Police and deputies from the Sheriff's Department will partner with BPD officers to ensure that visitors and tourists have an enjoyable experience while visiting Baltimore.
I started about 3 years ago. I was here attending career day, and while I was attending career day, I happened to be at the school principal's office. They have a portrait of a police officer in the office. I started inquiring about the portrait. She told me that the school was named after a police officer from the city who was killed in the line of duty. I was thrown back by the having a school named after a police officer.
Nothing was ever put officially in the school explaining who the school was named after.
And I didn't know either. I mean, it's kind of ironic. You're at a school here where kids are learning every day, but our job also, we're learning every day. And this was something that I learned a couple of years ago when Major Delgado called me out and talked about how we wanted to put together a program to rededicate the school that was named after an officer who was killed in the line of duty. And the first thing I said to him was, what school? And he mentioned Calvin Rodwell. I said, that's the school at Hillsdale and Liberty. He's like, yeah. He goes, that's the school. I was like, it's named after an officer? And he's like, yeah.
I don't think there's any school in the country that's named after a police officer that's been killed in the line of duty.
But all those years working up here in Park Heights, I never knew that. And I can guarantee you, so did a lot of other guys that worked with me, didn't know it either. Jake was telling me from Motors that he found out when he actually got a call inside the school. And when he went in there, he saw the picture of Officer Rodwell and like a small little like caption explaining it. So this morning, you know, part of the dedication, what we did is, you know, on behalf of the BPD and the FOP, we have a plaque there now that's going to be permanently affixed that will, you know, show that Calvin Rodwell was a police officer and was not just an officer, but a friend to a lot of kids back then. He was, I guess, what they call the original officer friendly.
Well, it was actually quite impressive. The children actually knew his middle name, and they knew a little bit about him as a person, about his passions. So I have to really give that respect back to the school that they've cared enough to make sure the children who attend here know why they come to a school named after a fallen police officer. So we pretty much came up to do an official plaque and rededication to the school. An official plaque will be affixed to the front wall of the school.
Were we able to find family members?
Yes, with the help of Warrant Task Force and the ATF side, we found his son, Dino Rodwell. After I had done a little bit of research online to find out that I knew there was two surviving siblings in the name of Kimberly Swinton and Dino Rodwell, ATF Detective Lansing went out and found Dino Rodwell, put me in touch with him, and he's been my go-to for the family to get everybody here today.
Right here, this is a floating basket. We put this basket in the water, and we can put you in this basket, and we'll put you on our boat and take you to safety. So we've got to do everything on the water. We're your police on the water. We're also one of your rescue tools.
I'm just glad that you all took time out your busy schedules to come and just really show the children something that they never normally see before. For example, you know, knowing the different little units within the police department, they didn't know anything about them.
Wave.
Oh, your paw.
They love the helicopter, they love the horses, they love that dog. They want to go to the motorcycle.
No, this is your speedometer and this is called a tachometer. This tells us how fast we're going. This tells us the engine speed, how fast the engine is going. Okay? And over here, when, once you turn on the lights, the switch, this operates your lights. See the light up here being on? Okay? And then the way we can tell that the lights are on, this is called a P, it's called a pursuit switch.
Because you know, in the city, there's this stigma that the police are bad people. But by them coming out here and showing the kids that they really aren't bad people, they're here to help. And the things that they do for the community, I think, is a wonderful thing.
This is the mom's room.
So what have you learned?
My goodness, first of all, I didn't know the dogs had sweat glands between their feet. Okay. So I did learn that.
How do you get him to jump?
He likes to jump. He likes to play. He's very playful.
You having fun?
Yes, I am. It's actually nice out here. All right. Get to see the horses. Canines, bikes, equipment up there.
You're going to back up a little bit? What do you like best?
The horses.
You're getting a warm welcome from everybody. How does it make you feel knowing that you can be a part of it?
It makes me feel like I felt when I was in the academy. The whole reason I joined the department, you know, to give back. You know, everybody, my grandfather used to always ask me, because I, you know, as a kid, you complain a lot. And he used to always say, well, what are you doing about it?
Right.
And I joined the department to do something about it. So now that I'm doing something about it, I'm seeing that it's being received. And that's what, you know, that's fulfilling. That's what you want.
My young ladies, line up here in front of me. My young men, on the other side of my.
So once they get the idea, and they understand what that word means, and we say sit, they sit, we give them the reward, they start doing the behavior, sitting, more quickly. And they start doing it to get the reward.
Police officers really do care. They do, especially about our children. That's something I definitely do. Because they provided all of this, they provided lunch.
One of the happiest days of my career is today. I mean, as a district commander, every day running from situation to situation, always in the negative light.
Just to see all the children out here learning firsthand about police officers, police work. One of the biggest passions of Officer Rodwell was the trust level that children should have for police officers. And what better way to get them out here, to get them introduced to the bomb squad, canine mounted, in ways they would never see in a positive light.
This running to this situation has been nothing but positive for me. Yep, feel very good.
BPD-TV is recorded live Monday through Friday at 12:30 p.m. It allows members of the Baltimore Police Department to share information directly with the community.
BPD-TV is produced from police headquarters daily by members of the public affairs staff and really focuses on behind-the-scenes work that detectives are doing, things that the police department needs help with, such as suspect descriptions, vehicle descriptions.
We talk about crimes that have gone on over the past day. It allows us to talk about citizen on patrol walks that happen almost daily throughout the city.
It's TV our way. Our detectives do a lot of great work, and that work often goes unnoticed, and we get a chance to show just what they're doing. Again, as I stated, you get the media side of the stories. In so many cases, the stories are slanted. They have objectives, they have missions. They're in the business to sell, and that's not our case. We want to put our story out there our way. Here lately, our objective is going after these bad guys with guns. For a change, we get to show exactly what we're doing, how we're doing it.
We've gotten a lot of great feedback regarding BPD-TV. And I think it's something that we're going to continue to do. And, you know, as time goes on, it'll get even better and we'll add things. But all in all, when people ask me what BPD-TV is, I just tell them it's a great way for the Baltimore Police Department to get their message out and to showcase the best of the Baltimore Police Department and its officers.
Members of the Baltimore Police Department began working with officials from the Maryland Jockey Club and Pimlico Racecourse to plan for a successful Preakness 2012, months and months before race day.
Welcome to Preakness Infield Fest. I, Kegasus Lord and Protector of said Infield Fest, want you here now. Where are you? You're out there. Where are my Mug Club people? Right here.
What could be described as the premier event in Maryland, the 137th running of the Preakness Stakes took place in Baltimore. Police Commissioner Fred Bielfeld joined State's Attorney Greg Bernstein and former Deputy Director of the CIA, Buzzy Krongard, who currently serves as President of the Baltimore Police Foundation, to personally thank officers for their work over the years. Commissioner Bielfeld and the team personally met with hundreds of officers as they walked the infield of the track, thanking them for their service. The commissioner gave officers a 2011 commendation, noting the significant reduction in violence that officers achieved in that year. Commissioner Bielfeld joined members of the Special Operations Section on the roof of Pimlico Racetrack to watch the 82nd Airborne Division of the United States Military give a special salute to attendees of the race. This event also included a flyover by a B-2 stealth bomber and a honor guard from the United States Navy.
One of the things, Mary Beth, as I was going around the track, we graduated a police academy class last night at 5:30. And some of those young men and women are ringing in the track today. So it's my last Preakness, but they're first. I'm looking at them thinking, wow, what an impression this is going to make on the start of their career, their voyage. And so it's bringing back a lot of memories for me as a young rookie police officer the things that I experienced in the city, the World Series up on 33rd Street, you know, seeing the Inner Harbor develop, all of those kinds of things. It's the last time I'm going to be at the Preakness wearing this uniform.
The 2012 Preakness Infield Fest featured performances by Grammy Award winners Maroon 5 and multi-platinum rapper Wiz Khalifa. Just after 6:30 p.m., the 137th Preakness Stakes was run at Pimlico Racecourse. Bodemeister got the trip he wanted, and he led easily through most of the race. However, as the stretch run progressed, Bodemeister was valiantly defending the lead, and I'll Have Another was grinding, inching closer to him in a superb duel as both drew away from the rest of the field with ease. I'll Have Another caught Bodemeister in the last strides to win by a head in a thrilling finish.
All right, so Major, I'm looking at a lot of money, a lot of guns, bulletproof vest, a lot of drugs. What is this a result of?
You know, this is a result of the district's efforts in the community, specifically speaking the 4700 block of Liberty, where we've had historical violence in that area. And this is just another result of our commitment to that area, where we obtained some information and our operations were quick in sinking their teeth into the information. And this is the end result: drugs, guns off the street, and a lot of money and a bad guy that was taken off the street.
Obviously, this is good work. Tell me, who did it? Who put in the work?
Our operations unit, Sergeant Gladstone, Lieutenant Hans and his staff, committed officer, they go out. This is the type of work that they do. This is the end result. This is exactly what we're committed to do in the community. This is what we get. Pretty happy and pleased to see that.
Is this a regular street corner dealer? Is this a mid-level supplier?
From the looks of the guns and the amount of cash and the amount of drugs, this is a mid-level to upper distributor of narcotics. So this is not local average street corner dealer. This is a guy who supplies those guys, and this is a good sort of taking the head off the snake.
And then I guess to the people in the community that this affects, what word do you have to them, the good people? What word do you have to them, I guess, as far as what you're doing and your continued efforts?
The community should be pleased with the work that we're doing up there. From the looks of these handguns, this is not your little slingshot type of handguns. These are assault weapons. This is stuff that can hurt people, and this is the stuff that contributes to the violence in that area. This is the commitment that we have, is to curb the violence in the community.
Be sure to catch the 19th episode of Police Beat. But for now, thank you for watching.